Charles, I had an argument with Charles.
What? About what?
I said that dolphins are the only animals that have sex for fun.
You can have a debate. That's not true.
I didn't even know that.
Google it. Google it.
That's not true.
Google it.
That's not true.
Google it.
That's not true.
I'm going to Google it, Charles.
They have sex for fun?
Yes.
I have extensively most animals, read the world's most educated and experienced primatologist, Robert Sapowski, will tell you otherwise.
Sounds like a fake name.
He's the head of neuroscience at Stanford University. And he has multiple best-selling books.
Well, I don't know how that shit works. I don't give a fuck anyways. Who the fuck?
Google's not a reliable source.
Why are we even arguing about this fucking dolphin?
I'll tell you why.
Fucking dolphin.
Did you see the tattoo he has?
No.
Show him the tattoo. That's what it started with.
What's the shark?
That's Earl Spence.
Listen. Look up bonobo apes. Okay? I'm telling you. This is stuff I've been studying for decades. I have 4 college degrees, 2 masters, and a PhD.
Who gives a fuck if a dolphin has sex or not? I don't give a fuck.
I don't say stuff because I haven't studied it in depth. I have a bachelor's degree, 2 master's degrees, and a PhD.
See? So what the fuck?
Okay, who in the gym? Let me ask you this. Who in the gym has the best nickname?
Huh?
Who has the best nickname in the gym?
Best nickname?
Yeah.
Wow. Let me see.
The nickname I gave Virgil's one of the best.
Which what?
Divergenator. Because you know when you fight him, you're going to get fucked.
This motherfucker. Rayos, nice fucking...
Rayos?
Rayo Valenzuela.
His name is Jose.
Yeah, but everybody knows my Rayo.
Nobody knows
his name is Jose. Everybody says Rayo.
Oh, we got
Rayo.
Chepe's got a good one. Chepe, the milk hunter. The Bill Hunter?
Hey, Sicario.
It's already taken.
Then we have Mowgli.
Mowgli.
El Mowgli. We got Mowgli right there.
That's a good
Mowgli.
One. He has it.
You got
He has a tattoo of
the
it too.
Mowgli.
Mowgli.
What's your real name?
Eh?
Nobody
Jose
knows.
Jose Luis.
No, tell no more. It's Mowgli.
Jose Luis Vasquez.
Is that Rayo? Then we have Hey, Emiliano, did you think
the Dolphin? The Dolphin.
No. Huh? Okay, so you don't. Okay, it comes natural. Okay, we don't. Okay, don't try to find one.
What's Louis' nickname?
It doesn't have a nickname.
King Louis.
King Louis. There you go. King Louis. That's right.
And then Lindolfo OnlyFans.
Thank you.
Is that a real nickname?
I give it to him.
He should be sponsored by OnlyFans.
Yeah, he should have an OnlyFans. Lindolfo.
Bam.
Bam. Panterita has a nickname.
Does it matter if a fighter has a nickname or not, Robert?
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't make a difference?
No. At all.
What about marketing, like the image? No.
Doesn't
make a difference. Just win.
No.
What's your nickname?
Gallo Fino.
Which means what?
The fine rooster.
Gallo Fino. Oh, yeah.
Gallo Fino. It's a tradition.
¿Por qué tienes samurai?
Oh, samurai, we have a samurai. Nobody knows his name.
¿Por qué tienes samurai?
His hair.
Samurai.
Yeah, Damien Sosa.
Yeah.
No, you have a lot of good kids here. You don't have head cases. Everybody's like a good person, Robert.
Misael?
There he is. Chino. Chino Maidana, Chino Misael, the 2 Chinos in 1 gym. So, Robert, what happens when Spence fights Fandora?
Hopefully they do. I want to see that fight.
It's going to happen in Dallas. 80,000 fans.
You think so?
Samson told me they're going to do that. It's going to sell, and they're going to make a lot of money.
Let's. I'm hoping that Spence is better off at 154. That'll show that maybe 147 was just... He grew out of it already and couldn't do it, and that's why he got destroyed by Crawford. Spence got the skills, so I would probably favor Spence, but Fontora, you know, it's just like most of the world was favoring
Tim Zhu, yeah?
Tim Zhu, you know, but Fontora's awkward guy, man. That's what makes him so good, that he's fucking so awkward and difficult for anybody, and he wins.
So Oscar De La Hoya posted on Twitter yesterday, Virgil versus Crawford, the biggest money fight for both.
Right now, Virgil's number one for the WBA, so we're going to go after that one. I think that's the best one for Virgil. And then, end of the year, we can fight Sue, we can fight anybody I went for. And then we're going to go to 160.
What do you think about Oscar posting videos about Rolly after the loss?
Well, they have beef with, you know, I wouldn't have done it, but hey, you know, they don't like each other. Rolly's been talking shit about Oscar and Golden Boy Promotion. So he's got all the right to do it. It was funny.
But you didn't expect it.
It was funny, so fuck it. You know, he did what, you know, what he felt he wanted to do, and it was funny.
So, Virgil. I gotta go. What does Rolly do now, Robert?
Rolly?
Yeah.
Still get a few good fights.
He's a name?
Yeah, he's still a name. Maybe just take advantage of that. Get a few fights, a few wins. I can't say a few wins, but a few fights, a few good paydays.
And then what does Pitbull do? He could fight at 40, Pitbull, 35.
I think him against Tang would be fucking huge.
In Mexico, U.S., Vegas?
U.S., Vegas.
And what weight, 40 or 35?
With that, wherever they want, wherever Tang wants. Just don't put a rehydration cost on all that bullshit. They do that a lot.
But Robert, if you're the A side, you could put whatever you want.
You're not people don't. To.
Why not?
Ellie, you're not supposed to.
If you're the A-side, you take the turns.
That's why there's the weight division. If you make weight the day of the fight, then that's it. You know, when the opponent comes in heavy, doesn't make weight, then you can say, okay, you're too heavy already. You already got a fucking 3 or 4 pound advantage over me. By tomorrow, you can weigh so much, then I understand that. Because that's already protecting your fighter. But when it comes to making weight, who gives a fuck how much you're going to weigh the next day? There should not be a fucking clause. There should not be.
So why would fighters agree to sign it then?
Then that's their fault. And then they can complain. Then they can complain. If they agreed, because this is the biggest fight.
It's part of negotiations,
people
right?
Fighting Mayweather, people fighting Canelo, people fighting Tank, they do it because that's the biggest fight, the biggest fucking opportunity, the biggest fucking payday. So they agree to it.
Would you agree to it with your fighters if you fought
but
someone?
But the fighters should, no. Well, if we fight one of those guys, probably would because the fighter's going to make the biggest fucking payday of his...
Ryan made like 35
million. You can't stop him from making that kind of money. That you know what I mean? But the fighters that do it shouldn't do it. If they make weight, they make weight. They shouldn't be worried about how much you're going to gain. You can't gain more than so much. That's not right. It's just not right.
So we are less than 3 weeks away from Ryan and Haney. Have you been following Ryan on social media?
Not really.
What do you think now, Robert?
Not really.
He looks like he's getting in shape.
I haven't heard anything, so that means he's training. Plus, I talked to Lupe.
What did Lupe say?
I talked to Lupe, honestly, and Lupe told me, look, Robert, honestly, he's doing much better. He's doing so good right now. He's focused. He's training. So I'm like, all right, I'm happy for that, you know. Because, you know, at a few weeks ago, you know, I'm not his family. I'm not his. But from what we see on social media, you kind of feel bad, you know, like can somebody help this kid? You know, because we've seen him grow up in the amateurs here in Southern California. The kid and his family, his dad, they've always been very respectful to me. They've never shown. I've never had any difficulties with them. I've never had anything against them. So I don't want to see anything bad happened to him, but Lupe told me he was doing good, so I believe that.
And what about the fight itself? How do you see it unfolding?
Well, you know, Ryan's got that speed and that power, so if he lands, he has a chance of hurting Haney. Haney's been hurt before, but I see Haney fighting just a very smart fight. I don't think he's going to try to go in there and make that mistake where he gets hit with a fast left hook. I think he's going to fight smart. And maybe cruise through a good decision. You know, I would love to see Ryan pull it off because that's my boy.
He has a chance.
Because I like him. He's Southern California. You know, Haney's Northern California, which I could also support if he's fighting somebody else. But at this point, I'm going to be supporting Ryan.
And then the big announcement last week, Bam against Guy Estrada.
Correct.
Everybody's excited about it. I've seen people
fight.
Say, we can't wait till June. What feedback are you getting, Robert?
It's going to be a badass fight. Same
two pound for pound fighters going
same
at it.
Same thing. Both fucking fighters are badass. It's going to be a badass fight. You know, when Maxim told me that Bam's next date was going to be June 29, they were going to push for Gallo. But if it wasn't Gallo, that, you know, we could go after the IBF or another one of the champions. And I told Bam. And Bam told us, if it's not Gallo, I'd rather wait because his baby's going to be newborn.
Yeah.
So he says, I'd rather spend a few more months with my baby and fight towards the end of the summer, early fall or something. But it's Gallo, so yeah, he's
that's
motivated to fight Gallo. He wants, you know, that's all he wants, man. Bam doesn't get motivated if it's a fight that doesn't make sense for him. He wants those big fights, and that's why he's going to train hard. And he's going to be motivated. He's motivated for this fight.
He's only 23.
He's against Gallo.
He's only 23, but
24. He turned 24 in January.
One of the best resumes in boxing.
He's
already
got a good resume already.
If you look at who he's fought the last
four
fights.
If he beats Gallo, you know, right there at 24, you could already say he's a Hall of Famer. He already beat three Hall of Famers, maybe even four Hall of Famers, and Sonny Edwards.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah.
So the gym's packed, and Virgil and Jose have a fight on the 27th.
27th. We have two more on that card. We have Oscar Duarte fighting Giorgio Diaz on that card. Right, you know. And then we have Figo fighting on that card too. You know, he trains with Virgil, so he's gonna fight on that card. So we have four. We're gonna be busy that weekend, but it's gonna be nice because it's gonna be in Fresno. People show up in Fresno. It's gonna be a fucking badass card.
Break it down to two main event cards. You know your fighters in
Virgil and Jose. You know Jose fighting Bartolome. Awkward guy, difficult guy, but
Cuban former champion, multiple time champion.
He's there, he's there. So it's gonna be a good fight. Virgil fighting Delorme. You know, Virgil was gonna fight somebody else. I can't think of the name right now, but we had another opponent from England, like a 27-2. Guy, good guy, good fight, good record. But I don't really know what happened. They told us last minute he's not fighting, we have to bring somebody else. They told us Delorme is available, it's approved. Fuck it, let's do it. Let's do it.
You were in Phoenix, you had a great night. What's next for your guys? What's next for Ray? Next for Lindolfo?
Lindolfo, they told us he's gonna be back sometime in August. Art Barrera, it looks like he might be back in May. And Raymond, I'm working on trying to get him something quick. You know, he has four straight wins by knockout, great performances against good fighters. And everybody obviously expected him to do the same thing. Friday night, that didn't happen. He went all 10 rounds, which is actually not a bad thing also to go all 10.
Put in some rounds.
But it wasn't his best performance. We know that, he knows that. But you know, there's no excuses. It was just the way it is. It's just part of boxing. I already talked to Top Rank. I'm gonna try to bring him in. Quick as soon as possible so he can come back and look explosive and get back to where he was, you know. But he's ready for champions, he's ready for any world title at 135. You know, Shakur is the champion. I think Raymond's number two in the WBC. WBO, you know, it looks like maybe Lomachenko's gonna be champion. IBF, WBO, maybe Navarrete. They all fight for top rank, so hopefully we
easy
get a title.
To make.
Hopefully we make a title fight this year. And if that doesn't work, then we're gonna have to go after the 140 pounders.
You just spoke to Shakur moments ago on
yes,
FaceTime. Shakur said, Robert, I wanna bet if I fight Ray, I want a $100,000 bet.
I told him I don't have that money, man.
But if you had that money, would you do it?
He makes millions. I don't make millions. He makes millions of dollars.
As he should. He's one of the best fighters.
Of course. I can't bet $100,000. That's, you know, I told him I'll bet $100. Just take the $1,000 out. You know, I don't like to bet, especially on my fighters. I never do.
Why?
I never put money on my fighters. And even though sometimes, like these guys, my both Vita, Chepe, Payo, they make a lot of money because they fucking put in. They know how to do all that shit.
Son once made a lot of money. I was there with him.
For the Maloney fight.
Yes.
Chepe. Bayo made like $30,000 that day. And they continue making money. All those, you know, they do parlays and all that shit. I don't, you know. Bayo made like $4,000 on the Pitbull fight. Pitbull versus Rollies. And he bet under nine rounds. Under round nine, I think that you could go on rounds.
And he made $4,000?
And he made like $4,000.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So you know, but I don't put money on my fighters. So, you know. Fuck, you know, this guy's coming like if I was a millionaire. I don't make $1 million.
But do you like his confidence that he's here?
Nah, he's, I like that. You know, he's fucking talented. But it's good that, you know, that he was also nice about the fight. You know, he wasn't talking shit. He's not talking shit to me. And I respect him. I respect him for that, you know.
He's a three-division,
you know,
champion.
I'm a little, I can't say disappointed because it's also business. And it could also be his last fight for Top Rank. So maybe Top Rank didn't want to feed him one of their fighters. Maybe he's like, okay, this is my last fight. Maybe he's not getting a huge payday. So fuck it, fight a guy that lost his last fight. You know, it kind of seems like it, to me, that's the way it is. I don't think
he wasn't aware that they offered him.
I don't think he's afraid of fighting anybody because he's one of the best fighters. So he took that fight. You know, to me, it doesn't look too good because he's fighting a guy that lost his last fight. And you're pound for pound one of the best fighters in the world when it comes to talent. So he could have said, no, find me somebody else. But it is his last fight with Top Rank, from what I understand. So I don't blame him either. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but he just told me a second ago that he didn't know that no one passed him the message.
Okay, you know, and we told Top Rank 3-4 weeks ago. Can you guys also? We know when we heard that Shakur had a date July 6th or something like that. I said, please bring up Raymond. I guess they didn't, and I also understand Top Rank. They know this might be his last fight with Top Rank, so why would they risk? You know what I mean? So I also understand them. So I don't blame them. I'm not mad at anybody. Shakur's doing his thing. He might move on and go somewhere else. And if he sticks with Top Rank, but then hopefully we can do that fight.
If Ryan beats Haney and Shakur fights Ryan, who wins?
Then that means Shakur moves up in weight. Then that leaves the title vacant. So we fight for the vacant title. Hopefully he does that.
Who wins that fight?
Who and who?
Ryan Garcia, Shakur Stevenson.
I think Shakur.
Shakur and Haney?
That's a good one, man. But I probably still pick Shakur.
Shakur and Pitbull?
I think Shakur.
Why?
Tough. Pitbull's gonna give anybody a tough fight,
bro. You always said that, yeah.
Pitbull's gonna give anybody trouble. Just like Camarón Cepeda will. He'll give anybody trouble. But it's a... But I still think Shakur is so talented that he probably wins the decision.
And then Ryu came in today. I've never seen this. First day of camp. He's on weight and he's already sparring. Who does that, Robert?
Fucking Ryu don't give a fuck, man. That's why he got the last win so impressive. Because same thing, he came in the first day last time and sparred right away. And he's motivated, he's ready, he's gonna fight the rematch that he lost actually, so it's a very dangerous fight. But he says, I'm gonna win this time, and that's why he's here so early and already sparring.
What do you think about Dos Santos and him?
Dos Santos is a fucking tough motherfucker, man. You know, he dominated. He knocked him out the first time. But Ryu says this time that's not gonna happen. I'm gonna knock him out, and that's a good mentality to have. Because Ryu did drop him. So if he fights smart, if he uses his skills, then he'll pull it off.
If you're Terrence Crawford, you were waiting for Tim Zhu to beat Pandora, but Tim Zhu lost. Now Pandora is gonna do something else. What do you do if you're Crawford right now? You obviously gonna
wasn't
make
there
it.
A fight with him and Ben, Conor Ben or
no, the other guy, Chris Eubanks.
Chris Eubanks?
That disappeared.
Well,
I don't
think. Do that at 160.
Okay, in England?
If that, see, because now he can't fight Tim Zhu because Tim Zhu just got beat and
his cut. Yeah.
So Fundora might be fighting Spence, like you say. I didn't even know that.
That's what Samson told me.
Okay, so then that might be going on. So then he has to find something big. I doubt he stays at 147. So go fight, what, Eubank?
Or they have someone else in line. Guy named Jeff from England. I'm not sure.
But that doesn't make nothing for Crawford.
For the belt, he could win a belt.
Crawford wants those big fucking fights, man.
What about becoming a champion 54? What if they strip Fundora and the WBO has him fight?
You know what fight would probably make sense? And I think he probably wins. After Canelo fights Munguia, maybe he could fight Munguia.
Yeah.
Because I don't think Munguia is much taller than Crawford. Maybe an inch. And Crawford's got really good skills. Maybe he moves up to get Munguia. And if he beats Munguia, then he could get Canelo.
But the only problem with that is, Robert, that means he'll be 37, 38 years old by the time
that happens. But Munguia's going to fight in May. Munguia could fight in September again.
Okay. So that means Crawford
unless he gets cut or gets knocked the fuck out so bad that he can't fight. But he could fight, you know, Munguia fights in May, early May. So he could easily fight August or September against Crawford. And that's a big fight for Crawford.
Maybe. Let's see what happens. Any message to your fans? What's next for you, Robert? Anything this weekend?
We have this. Yeah, we have fights this Saturday in Mexico City. I have Chop Chop, Albert Gonzalez, fighting in Mexico City this Saturday, and so is Leonardo Ruiz. They're both fighting in Mexico City.
They're both very talented?
Yeah, both very talented. Next, what is that? The following week, on the 13th, Saturday, Louis Coria fights in Corpus Christi.
Whose card is that?
Top rank.
Nice, Louis. You were top rank.
Louis fighting in Corpus. The following then on the 20th we have two. Where's the Emilianos? They left.
They left.
All right. Yeah. Both Emilianos fighting in Mexico City and Samurai and Mowgli. Oh no, Samurai's not fighting.
No, just
Mowgli.
He's fighting a guy that trained here.
Yeah. He's fighting the 24th. Yeah. He's fighting the 24th. So they all have dates. Then Pantera. No, you fight.
I fought the 13th.
The 13th also in Chicago, right over there, Wisconsin or wherever. Yeah.
Chicago.
Yeah, he fights in Chicago.
Where is Jeffrey Dahmer?
Pantera.
No, I haven't seen him today.
Back in Milwaukee.
Where's Jose Luis?
In the house.
He already left?
Yeah.
Okay, so they both fight April 27 in Texas, where obviously we're not going to be able to make it because they already know, but that's fine. They'll take care of business.
Because you'll be in Fresno.
Yeah. So we got dates every fucking weekend, pretty much.
That's amazing. Well, this is going to be very busy.
Well, May 4th, that's Canelo's date. We don't have anybody fighting that weekend. But then we do the next May 11th. We have May 11th.
Where's that?
May 11th in Aguascalientes.
Where's Louis?
And here in Long Beach. So we have two dates. Then May 18th, Santillan.
Hopefully for the title. Hopefully by then.
I believe it's probably going to be. If it's for the title, it's going to be an interim because Crawford hasn't vacated.
Hopefully
so,
he does by then.
I don't know. Well, he's lined up to
fight. Who's he going to fight? You know yet?
I'm not sure yet.
Let's see him.
And then I don't know the name. We already have an opponent, but I don't even know the name.
But it's at home, so hopefully Santiago can
And then we have. Then on the 24th, he fights on the 24th in Florida against.
Yeah,
con Valle,
right? What weight class? 54, 60?
154.
He's a big 54.
Yeah, he's still 54.
He could spark Canelo for Munguia if you want.
Yeah, he could.
Do you want to spark Canelo for Munguia?
See, that's it right here.
Yeah.
Against Marquez Valle.
Yeah, let's see it. Marcus used to train here.
Yeah, he's a very dedicated kid.
Yeah, him and his brother were here.
Kid, him and his brother.
I like that fight. Is it for belt or something?
It's a good fight. It's a really good fight.
Just for money.
And then, we got dates every fucking weekend.
That's very busy, Robert. But if you build it, they will come. Is Jose fighting for belt?
Jose who?
Ramirez.
No, I believe not.
Okay, what about Virgil?
Just a 10-rounder.
Okay.
Yeah.
But everyone's gonna. You have a lot of champions this year, hopefully.
No, but we're gonna have a good few months. Next few months.
But how did they? Let me ask you this, Robert. So you go to Phoenix. You've been there a few times. The fans are big supporters of you. How did they receive you this time?
Love, man.
Packed
nothing
house,
but love, man. Yeah. Nothing but love, man. It was great. You know, I had a little bit of a controversy with one of the commissioners, which I didn't see him after because they moved him to another locker room. But I actually wanted to apologize because I did tell him something that I shouldn't have told him. But it was he didn't do what he. If you're going to say it to somebody, you got to say it to everybody in the locker room. Not let others get away with it.
Correct. And not pick on you, yeah.
Exactly. So that's what happened.
So you had to put him in check a little bit? Yeah,
I kind of did, but said stuff that I shouldn't.
And then they moved him.
And they moved him to another locker room.
Listen.
I would have wanted to see him after to apologize, but I didn't get a chance.
He'll probably watch this. Everybody does.
Hopefully.
All right, so everybody follow Robert Garcia Boxing. A lot of big fights coming up, and I'm excited about Bam's fight and Virgil.
Can't wait for that one, man. Jose, that's going to be a fucking sick-ass fight. It's going to be a good card, too, because I think Sonny Edwards is on that card, and I have three spots there, so I'm going to have three of my guys on that one.
By the way, I think Errol Spence bet $100,000 on Fundora. Uh-huh. It was like a 6-1 underdog.
So he made like $600,000.
And then he bet $40,000 on Pitbull.
Good
which
shit.
You make back another probably 5,000 off that.
Yeah, good stuff.
So he made
He banked. I'm sure my boy Chino made some money too. He always makes money in Vegas.
On the sure one. So there you have it. Stay tuned right here. RGBA. Another day. Cold Charles in the house. Reporting.
Ellie Sekback, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.